Hey, welcome back to another Mr. Excel podcast. I'm Bill Jelen. I'm here in New York City at the World Championship ModelOff Competition. We have Martijn again.
Hey, it's another Mr. Excel netcast. I'm Bill Jelen. I want to set up today's problem before we jump over to the solution. So we have a database here, right? And you see that there are some ties in the sales column, some people that have the exact same revenue. And our goal today is to sort this whole thing with the formula. Well, the sales portion is easy, equal large of this array over here. I'll press F4, comma, the first will give us the largest value. And as we copy that down, large is really good at handling ties. So it knows that there were three customers with 100,000, two customers with 10,000. And it, you know, it doesn't give us a hassle that, hey, these are tied at sixth. You know, it gives us one at sixth and one at seventh. But then the problem is when we do the VLOOKUP to go back and get the customers, it's not going to work because we're always going to get the first customer who had a million twice, and the first customer had 100,000 three times, and the first customer had 10,000 twice. So you never get the other customers. All right, let me set the stage there. We'll jump back to the model off.
This is a cool trick. So let's switch over to Excel. Martijn, tell us what's going on here.
Yeah, this is a trick I recently learned. Somebody asked me, how can you automatically rank content? Now, the issue is, if you've got duplicate numbers, so I've come up with a very simple example here. It's got 434, 34 again, and some other numbers. If you would use a normal large function using this content, the number itself would be fine. But if you want to match this number to something, imagine this is a market cap, and you want to match this with the company, it's not going to know the difference between this 434 and this 434. So it's going to pull the same company name, HP and BHP.
So the second company never ever shows up in the
exactly.
Results.
I mean, you're fine if you just need the number, but the moment you want to use that number to do something else, like matching right. Company name, you're in trouble. So what you can do, it's a very simple trick. You just add a little, like a billionth or a millionth to the number. And what we used here is just a simple row function, just to make sure that these numbers in this column here are unique numbers. You use the same formula as large formula again, which, as you can see here, is slightly different. If you just format this properly, you won't see the difference. So it's very important. And it allows you to use the VLOOKUP formula.
That's a hot trick. That's great. What a cool, cool way. No one will even see the numbers. They're there. They're way too small. We're using the row function to make it slightly different. And the VLOOKUPs work. This is great, everyone. You need to come to next year's 2013 ModelOff Final in New York City. We got Excel rock stars here. I'm learning so much. I'm Mr. Excel. Hey, we'll see you next time for another netcast from MrExcel.com.